to make the hit. Lynch, who's having a big day here. John Lynch. Now, they had the big blizzard here on Wednesday, Phil, and 40 members of the Bronco family never able to make it out of their complex. Lynch only able to make it home to join his family thanks to an assist by Champ Bailey.
That's right. Champ Bailey had a big, big truck, got him in there and fought his way through the snow.
Set up a screen. Watson. Derrick Williams by the ankle. Won't let go this time. That was actually Rudy Johnson, not Watson.
You know, as you watch John Lynch, Jim, on that first play, playing deep safety, 15, 17 yards away from the line of scrimmage. But when he recognized run, he was able to fly up, get there quick enough, and stop it for about a one-yard gain.
Now Watson's the running back, third and five. Palmer. And Foxworth makes the big play to deny Bushmanzada and Cincinnati of the first.
Dominique Foxworth, Jim, last week he played very well against the Arizona Cardinals, and he's off to a good start this time. Knowing the down and distance, that's what's important, and that's why he didn't get fooled too much by Bushmanzada and makes the tackle before he gets the first down.
Now Denver has a chance to do a little something here before the half. Got two timeouts to work with. Carson with no heat, able to deliver a good one. Backpedaling with the return, it's Williams. And a nice hit, leveling him by... Well, that was by Landon Johnson. Landon Johnson. After a 59-yard punt and a 10-yard run back. I mentioned earlier, Santa Claus, Indiana, just above the Kentucky border, the hometown of Jay Cutler. And they get a half million pieces of mail a year sent to Santa Claus.
I'm surprised it's not more. Yep. Just so I can get marked that it's been to Santa Claus, Indiana, of course.
Little bell in the backfield. See if the Broncos are able to do anything on the ground. Derrick Bell. And he fumbles. Lost a fumble last week that was returned for a touchdown at Arizona. Stripped away by Pecco, who's come up big. And the recovery by Cincinnati.
That's probably the first time, Jim, all day that I've seen good blocking up front to allow the Denver running backs to get a chance to get down the field and get some good, tough yards. But Pecco coming across does a good job showing what an athlete he is, avoids being cut by the offensive lineman, comes down and knocks the football out of the hands of Tatum Bell.
And Delta O'Neal, a former Bronco, with the recovery. Back-to-back weeks, lost fumbles by Tatum. Trying to strike right away to the end zone, and Bushmanzada is out. Makes the grab, but did not get the second foot down.
Good design by the Bengals. They get him down the field. Bushmanzada against John Lynch. And John Lynch having an all-pro year, but there is no way he is going to cover a wide receiver of this caliber down the field. Caution Palmer being too careful with the football. His overthrow, two gimme touchdowns. Well, three touchdowns today so far.
A long incompletion. 2.5 minutes to go in the quarter. Second and 10. And Rudy Johnson running hard to the 20 behind Bobby Williams and Willie Anderson. Good enough for a first.
Jim, just this game in this first half, it makes you understand why you have to be afraid of the Bengals passing game. They can get down the field fast, vertical, and if Carson Palmer's on the mark, they'd have quite a few touchdowns.
It'll bring us to the two-minute warning with the Bengals driving, trying to regain the lead off the turnover committed by the Broncos.
It's the sound of classic soul ballads. For the first time ever, all the most romantic soul hits are together in one collection. Time Life Music presents Classic Soul Ballads. 90 of the most beautiful, the most sensual, and the sexiest songs of all time. But if you order now, you can own the entire collection, 90 hits, on 6 CDs for just 4 easy monthly payments. But wait, call with your credit card and we'll send you a free Marvin Gaye Early Classic CD. That's an additional 18 tracks from soul legend Marvin Gaye. You'll get a total of 7 CDs, 108 of the greatest soul hits of all time. This special collection is not sold in stores, so call now with your credit card and get the Classic Soul Ballads collection and your free Marvin Gaye Early Classic CD. From soul legends to golden groups, this collection will touch your heart and make you feel good all over. Call the number on your screen now.
Live and
again, coming up, the Sprint Halftime Report with JB, Dan, Shannon, and Boomer all coming up. I heard that's 300-pound reference, by the way, to Boomer.
Well, you know, I exaggerated, of course. It's really only 280.
Yeah, I was going to say by 10 or 20 pounds.
Yeah, that's it. Our buddy Boomer.
First down from the 20. Just in the middle. It's Gonzaga pinballing around and forward progress to the 14. Give him 5. Warren and Wilson on the hit. Bengals have one timeout, but certainly plenty of time. They don't have to go to any extreme right now. Over to Rudy Johnson. Cutting inside the 10 for a first and goal to go before he is tackled from behind by Michael Myers. Gajcek doing a good job blocking for that one. Gained 8.
Yeah, Gajcek, center, coming in for Rich Braham, who, as Marvin Lewis said, he was the rock of our offensive line, and he's done a good job as the season's gone along, replacing maybe their most valuable offensive lineman.
Now first and goal with a minute to go in the quarter. Homer with time, and from behind he is brought down. Ebenezer on Christmas Eve. Ekubon with the sack, trying to spoil Christmas for Cincinnati. Ekubon had a big week last week, in on a sack here. Timeout, Bengals.
From Detroit, Michigan, the Seahawks are set to take on the Pittsburgh Steelers in Super Bowl 40. Third and goal with the 1. A bootleg left, and Ben dives for the goal line. It's a touchdown, Pittsburgh! And they hand it to Willie Parker. Finds a lane. It's on his way. Look up. Pittsburgh 45-50.
Jim Nance along with Bill Sims. Happy holidays to all of you. And Cincinnati trying to take the lead before the intermission.
Good job by Carson Palmer the last time. Breaks out of the pocket, has no idea that Ekubon is behind him, but the fact that he had two hands on the football prevented the fumble.
Chad Johnson left with Bailey on the coverage. Henry and Hushmanzada to the right. Second and goal from the 11. Palmer. Again, first option, close down, throws to the end zone. Catch is made. Henry with the reception and the touchdown. He's a big target, towering over Darrent Williams, and he took advantage.
I think you just described everything there, Jim. First, very good throw by Carson Palmer. It's double moves by the Bengals with the receivers. Nobody open. But in the back of the end zone, Chris Henry just so big and goes up in the air and just snatches the football out of the air and gets the touchdown.
All four touchdowns in this game have come on short fields. Drive starting in plus territory, and now Shane Graham with the extra point. The lead by three. When we met with the Bengals yesterday, they talked about Deron Williams with respect, but also the fact he's not a very tall corner. They thought they could get some mismatches.
Yeah, down here at the bottom, but watch what they do, Jim. What they're really trying to do is throw it to the two receivers on the inside who are making little moves and going back inside. Chris Henry really not even part of the play, the bottom of your screen, but Carson Palmer knowing nobody's open, nobody around him. He moves out of the pocket, and Chris Henry, what a job. Stays alive, and look at that. Just goes up and takes it with his hands out of the air.
This is his eighth touchdown of the year. Cincinnati, the only team in the league that has four players with at least seven touchdowns.
It's a team, and we heard Carson Palmer talk about it. They're not one of these teams that goes to the sideline. They don't care who's caught what. They just play. And then they know sooner or later that probably Chad Johnson's going to catch more because they designed more plays for him. But if you take him away, they're very happy throwing it to T.J. Bushmanzada or Chris Henry. Not many teams have that kind of depth or talent, whatever you want to say, at that position.
Not many that have the triple threat you're talking about.
Yeah.
You know, we saw Arizona last week. They're certainly up there. Now, Quincy Morgan. And he is finally finished off at the 27 by Medeo Williams. What will the Broncos do? Two timeouts to play with here. 37 seconds. 13-4 in first downs. Both Denver touchdowns coming off of turnovers. First a Bailey interception setting up one, then a Bailey fumble recovery forced by Foxworth, and a strike on the very next play long to Walker. Mike Bell replaces Tatum Bell, fresh off a fumble. They're not going to go shotgun, it appears.
Well, usually in a drive like this, Jim, situation, you're careful on first down. Draw screens or a safe throw.
There's the safe throw. Mike Bell, stiff arm. Effective. And cuts back to the inside, which may cost him a timeout. Got a first down. And a timeout called.
Well, really, so far today, this Bengals defense, they've been put in some really tough situations. But overall, the interception by Dexter Jackson, they have pressured Jay Cutler, given their offense good field position.
And just now, Bresnahan's crew allowing only a fifth first down of the game.
You know, and people, it's so easy to say, well, if the Bengals just had this, sir, they had more on defense. Well, it's hard to have a lot of stars on defense when you got about seven of them on the offensive side. You know, sometimes you got to pick what you want to be. And they've decided that right now that their power is on the offensive side. They've built the team around Carson Palmer and the defense. They get out there. They try to find different ways to get it done every week. When you play a team like last week, like the Colts, it didn't work.
With 26 seconds to go. Cover. The long ball unleashed and over the head of everyone, even Medeo Williams. It was Javon Walker in double coverage.
Marvin Lewis said to his defense this week, look, when you watch this film, there's one thing that's evident with this young quarterback. He doesn't underthrow guys. So when you think you're deep enough, keep running.
Well, that touchdown he threw last week was 63 yards in the air.
In the air, outside the pocket. He's basically on the 30 and doesn't even really get everything into it and throws it, I don't know, looks like down to about the 5-yard line.
Yeah.
So let's see, 65.
Yeah. Had to take off the shot, socks and shoes to count that high. And that was Kirkus on the slant.
Well, that was the shot hit to the shortstop. You go, well, it's not an error because that was just too hot to handle. And if you're going to throw it that hard, then you better stick it right into the chest of the wide receiver. See, I used to be an official scorekeeper, too, in baseball.
Oh, has returned. 15 seconds, third down, and again, one timeout. One big connection could bring out Elam, but instead, they're going to run it. Mike Bell, nothing doing. Jonathan Joseph comes up to make the tackle, and that should run out.
No, they should take a timeout, and Mike Shanahan's going to do it.
Yeah, look at the players are all leaving the field.
Yeah.
Look at Cincinnati trotting to the locker room.
See, this is not done enough by coaches in this league.
Especially when you're talking about the arm he has.
Yeah, I don't. Jim, move around as a quarterback. When you let him move around in a football game, the adrenaline, everything that goes on, especially in here in Denver, if you get the time to let the receivers get down there, you owe it to your team to give them one more chance.
Maybe draw a penalty if you don't get the miracle hookup.
Well, we saw it in Buffalo and Tennessee today. 1 second to go in the first half. They throw the Hail Mary. It's caught. Defensive penalty. Field goal almost helped Buffalo win the game.
Well, we just saw Cutler throw it 65 yards down the field. And, you know, that's what he'll, after dancing around for a while, if he's allowed that time, that's about what he'll need to do again.
That's the key. If you're the Bengals, rush four. If you rush three, the quarterback can watch the rush, and he can move around, and it will allow the receivers to get to the end zone.
So the Cincinnati bench has reassumed its position on the sideline. And instead, they go underneath, and Rod Smith drops the football.
Okay, so much for that Hail Mary to the end zone.
Yeah. They didn't send anyone deep. But an exciting first half it was. And the Bengals lead it 17-14. We're back with the Sprint halftime report after this message. And a word from your local station. Rudy Johnson, the first to score. Then a couple of Cutler touchdown passes. You're watching the NFL on CBS, home of Super Bowl 41.
And let me get you caught up on all the scores from the early games today. The Patriots capture their fourth straight division title with a three-point victory over the Jaguars. Tom Brady 20-4 in December. Patriots take it there. Tennessee Titans a one-point victory over the Buffalo Bills. As a result, the Bills are eliminated from postseason consideration while the Titans win their sixth straight. The Colts fall for the first time ever to the Houston Texans. Chris Brown's game-winning 48-yard field goal did it with no time left. They are now 1-9 Houston against the Indianapolis Colts. The Ravens, 31-7 winners over the Pittsburgh Steelers. Super Bowl champion Steelers are eliminated from postseason consideration. The Ravens match a franchise record with 12 wins. The Saints march into the Meadowlands and take care of business against the Giants. The Giants had 67 yards in their first series, only 75 the rest of the game. Panthers end a four-game losing streak, win it by 7 over the Falcons, a team record 52 rushes for the Carolina Panthers. The Chicago Bears, winners over the Detroit Lions. Bears, four straight wins overall, four straight also over the Lions. The Washington Redskins lose in overtime to the St. Louis Rams. Steven Jackson, a big game. He had the game-winning touchdown in OT, 150 rush yards and 102 receiving yards. And the Tampa Bay Buccaneers pick up their first road win with that 15-point victory over the Cleveland Browns. Coming up, we'll have all the highlights in the Sprint Halftime Report continues on CBS. New York studios and the Sprint Halftime Report. I'm James Brown along with my guys, Dan Marino, Shannon Sharp, and Boomer Esiason. Folks, as we take a look at the score there, Bengals on top of the Broncos, 17-14. That at the half. And just a headline note to pass along to you, the New England Patriots have captured their fourth straight AFC East title. And with Houston's victory earlier today over Indianapolis, San Diego now has a first round bye. Speaking of San Diego, let's get to the highlights, fellas.
Well, LT, a big first half, over 100 yards. Phillip Rivers right here, only 1 for 10 in the first half.
What?
And it happens to be a touchdown. Yes, only one
Pro
completion.
Phillip Rivers. Here, Matt Leinart would get sacked and lead, but not before he did this. Larry Fitzgerald, 6 yards, best hands in football, fifth. They're up 26.
And the New England Patriots, Lawrence Maroney, he goes 27 yards for a touchdown, putting them up by 10.
Woo!
Tom Brady, big day, 249 yards and a touchdown. Rodney Harrison recovers the fumble from David Garrard. The seal of victory, Brady talks about the win.
I think we're playing for one reason, that's to win a Super Bowl. And it's going to be quite a challenge, but... you know, at the end of the day, you know, I like our chances.
The Tennessee Titans used the 215-yard rushing day. Vince Young threw for 183 yards, 2 touchdowns. This one to Brandon Jones. They're up. Coach Dick Girard on fourth down did not think his field goal kicker could make a field goal into that stiff breeze, so J.P. Lossman comes back on the field. He heaved it up. Ronaldo Hill comes down with it as they went on the road. They won 7 straight, JB.
How about those Colts? They fall to 11-4, number 3 seed in the AFC playoff race. Baltimore goes up to number 2. They gave up 191 yards rushing. Peyton Manning tried to get the troops motivated, and Tony Dungy tells us at the end of the game, after this game-winning field goal kick, it's his fault.
I take the blame for it, for not having us ready to go and ready to play, and they outplayed us.
The Baltimore Ravens are now the number 2 seed thanks to 5 sacks from that defense, 2 INTs, and 3 touchdown passes. This one to Demetrius Williams as they win 31-7 over Pittsburgh.
Pathetic is the word for the Giants offense. Drew Brees, he throws for 132 yards. Reggie Bush over 100. Deuce McAllister over 108. And Tiki Barber does his best analyzing after the game.
I think we played hard. We just played stupid. And we made mistakes. And... you can't win that way. You know, it's painfully obvious. You know, not plainly, painfully obvious.
Hey, Chris Winkie throws a touchdown to Jeff King. And also the Carolina Panthers, get this, run the ball 52 times in 62 offensive plays for 183 yards.
Poor Arthur Blank.
Wow. Chicago got another solid day from Rex Grossman, guys. 3 in a row here. Bernard Berry at 13 yards as they go on the road and win 26-21.
Hey, Steven Jackson, big day, 150 yards rushing on 33 attempts, 252 yards total offense. Mark Bolger, 4 touchdowns on the day as St. Louis wins in overtime.
And Cleveland Brown quarterback Derek Anderson throws 4 interceptions, including this one right here to Derek Brooks. He takes it back, 21 yards for a TD. Tampa Bay goes on the win, 22-7.
All right, folks, and with that in mind, we'll take you out to the second half of the game. Denver Broncos, of course, right after this.
Hooday.
CBS Sports presents the Sprint Halftime Report. Sprint, together with Nextel. Power up. She's saving elephants. He's a piano virtuoso.
They were already assured of a white Christmas here in Colorado, but even a little more special here on Christmas Eve as the snow falls. Santa on hand watching a hard-hitting contest as each side's looking for a leg up in this wild card chase. The rookie, Cutler, throwing 2 touchdown passes in the second quarter, but the Bengals take advantage of a late first-half turnover and hit a strike of their own for the lead. And the second half is coming up as the NFL on CBS continues in a moment.
It's the most wonderful time of the year, with the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season.
It is the most wonderful time of the year, especially when you win. Jim Nance, Bill Simms, I know you feel it's the most wonderful time of the year, and I know how much you love celebrating Christmas with the whole Simms clan, but it's also that way because you love watching every single bowl game out there.
Yeah, well, I try to.
Getting harder, though.
This game brought to you in high-definition television. Holt, run back. It's a good one. Stepping out near the 35-yard line. All right, let's just talk, Phil, about the physicality of this game in the first half. It's a field goal lead by Cincinnati, but they have really, as far as you're concerned, they've dominated the line of scrimmage here.
Yeah, there's no question, Jim. When you look at the first half, I thought the Bengals were the more physical team, the more dominant, and they had many more chances to make plays down the field. So they go in at halftime and go, hey, guys, everything is there. Let's stop the mistakes. That's the only thing that has held the Bengals back.
Decisive edge in first downs, total yards, but the three turnovers, two interceptions, and a lost fumble by Chad Johnson. And Rudy Johnson falls backwards right near DJ Williams and Ebenezer Ekubon for a gain of four. Again, here's what's kind of happened so far today. San Diego has already clinched a first-round bye. Not the first seed, but a first-round bye. Baltimore moves up to the two spot. New England's won the division, the East. Pittsburgh's been eliminated. Buffalo's been eliminated. And Cincinnati, if it wins here today, will clinch a playoff berth. And Rudy Johnson. And Ekubon running him down. Meanwhile, again, if you're just joining us, for the Broncos, playoff hopes, win-win assured of being in the postseason.
You know what crossed my mind as I'm watching Carson Palmer and his hurry-up offense, or the no-huddle offense, as you call it, and what coach was it that said to us, don't worry about crowd noise? And we go, what do you mean? He goes, the crowd can't sustain. They get tired. They quit yelling. So if you go no-huddle, they give up as the game goes along.
Well, the fans here showing no signs.
They're hanging in there.
Of vocal fatigue. But we're just starting the third quarter, and it's a third and two. Watson easily with the first, and Foxworth has to come up and make the stick. Bushmanzada with the lead block.
Jim, what did we say the key for this Denver defense at the very start of the day? What is the key? The defensive line has to be terrific. They're not stopping the run well enough, and they're not consistently putting enough pressure on Carson Palmer, and that's why the Bengals moving the football at will.
And this snap coming right at midfield. Rudy Johnson returns to the backfield. And Rudy hit by Gold. Able to shake away. Look at this balancing effort. Only run down the line, no gain.
Larry Coryer, defensive coordinator for the Denver Broncos, and Mike Shanahan, he goes, hey, we got to change up. And that time, the linebackers got more aggressive. They got in a, came at that running back, and that's why you saw the Ian Gold in the backfield trying to make the tackle.
And there's defensive coordinator Larry Coryer. Johnson, second down run. And three Broncos bring him down. You know, not just in this game. And I understand how hard it is to make a tackle. At least I do from afar. But you watch games like Buffalo today, not able to make a tackle so often against Tennessee. The Colts been plagued by that all season. We're seeing Rudy Johnson break tackle. What's happened to the art of tackling?
Well, you know, isn't it funny? Dexter Jackson, safety for the Bengals, said the same thing does. And he goes, guys, too often go for the big hit. Just make the tackle, play the next down, quit trying to make highlight hits.
Third and six. Chad Johnson, with Bailey bringing him down, has the first down. So it's all about trying to be on the highlights again,
no,
huh?
Jim, it's not all that, but it is part of it. We've become such a culture about being really different. So you're not going to get any highlights or be talked about if you just technically are sound and make good tackles. You gotta blow somebody up, make the football fly, whatever, even though it's for a 20-yard gain, you gotta be spectacular. And that's part of the problem.
Timeout called by the Broncos, and they're moving the football. The Bengals, first drive of the second half.
Hi, I'm John Lynch.
Hi, I'm Champ Bailey.
And from our Bronco family to yours,
we want to wish everyone a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays.
Those two stalwarts from the secondary, Lynch and Bailey, both heading to the Pro Bowl, along with Wilson on that defensive side for Denver. Three Bengals getting selected this week, all on their offense. Pass through the fingertips of Chad Johnson. The timeout by Denver a moment ago.
Carson Palmer on the move again. Throws across his body. Really, that's a catch Chad Johnson makes. Almost 100 out of 100.
Why the timeout?
The timeout, it must have been a formation, Jim, that they didn't like personnel. They didn't match up well against the Bengals, so they called timeout to get some different people on the field.
Rudy Johnson hit down low by Foxworth. Holds him to a gain of only three.
So you're starting to see a few of the changes by this Denver defense. We saw the linebacker blitz, and that time, Dominique Foxworth from outside on the blitz, and they're doing this just to stop the run. It's not about getting to Carson Palmer.
Somewhere in the snow, up in the stands, Foxworth's mother and father. They're there. Lorenzo and Karen, they've never missed a game since he started playing football at the age of eight. Third and seven. And that pass way behind Stewart, who was drifting across the middle and open.
He was wide open, Jim, but Carson Palmer just, I don't know, a little quick with the football. Maybe it slipped, but the timing was not there.
50-yard field goal into the wind? No. They're going to go ahead and stay with the offensive unit. Fourth and seven.
Well, these snow flurries are starting to stick to the field,
yes,
too.
Yes, they are. Now the play clock looked to expire, and then finally now we're able to nullify this play and back up the Bengals five.
Delay of the game. Fourth down.
And will Marvin Lewis send in the punt team now?
Well, the offense is heading over.
Yes, he will. Again, you know, Jim, just again, the opportunities are there for the Bengals. And I know the conditions have gotten a little tougher, but receivers are getting open. The passing game just not clicking with them so far.
So Larson brought in a little pooch punt. He's had 23 punts dropped inside the 20 this year. Terrific net average this season as well. Touchback. Down on the, that's Holt.
Did he get his feet back in the field of play?
I agree. I think he had a foot on the line, which would bring a touchback. Carlisle saying, hey, look, guys, you can almost see the footprint here in the snow. The initial ruling on the field is down at the one. Well, the Broncos have challenged the ruling on the field. They say that Glenn Holt had not come back in the field to play when he downed the punt at the one. His right foot clearly in the end zone. Now watch, he plants here. Is that on the line, or is he reestablished that he's back in the field to play?
It's the step before he catches it. Here it comes.
This step right here is the...
No, the one before, and yeah, the one before. If we did it again, Jim, I think he was on the line. Will it be enough to make Walt Coleman overturn it?
The key step here, the right foot here. Is that one at all on the line? If it's touching the line.
He did not reestablish if that right foot is on the line. And from the reverse angle, Jim, from behind, I thought it was a, well, as definitive as you could get. Right here it comes. Now watch. It's on, don't you think?
Can't tell. Just can't say for sure.
Come on. You? Are you kidding me? Is this the same guy I hang out with every week?
Yes.
That knows the outcome of every sporting event before it happens?
You can say definitively that his foot was not on the line at all. Or you say it is on the line.
I from that second angle, I thought it was on the line, but is that enough? I can't say, hey.
Enough visual evidence.
Yes.
Well, you know, Marvin Lewis said to us, we need to be aggressive with our play calling, and we need to be good with our eyes. And this is where you really need to be good with your eyes right here.
You know, that was interesting when he said that. Being good with his eyes, he meant don't be fooled by some of the stuff the Broncos do. Well, they've been fooled.